If my hypothesis is correct, the Coolsville vampire killer is...
Frida Yankabitch!
Frida was furious that the town didn't vote her to be the head of city council, so she hid her identity with this mask and murdered every council member, so the city would have no choice but to hire her.
And I would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
Well, gang, that's another mystery successfully solved.
Why, zoinks, Fred. We wouldn't have been able to do it without your trap.
How'd you become so good with rope, Fred?
I get the feeling this is only gonna pleasure you.
Boy Scouts.
My hero.
Don't touch me. I mean, please don't touch me. I'm git. A germaphobe.
We should only get food to celebrate.
Jinkies, that's a swell idea.
Too bad Scooby can't come with us.
The vet said he still has a day or two of recovering from his neutering.
Did we really have to cut off his balls?
He wouldn't stop humping me.
And me.
And me.
We'll bring him back some Scooby snacks. What the fuck? Where's the mystery machine?
Jinkies, look!
Jeepers! It looks like the van got towed.
Legs, oinks, man. All of my weed was in there.
Fuck your weed! That van was my baby. There's nothing in this world that I love more than it.
What about me?
Not everything's about you, Daphne.
Just call the tow company and tell them who we are. I'm sure they'll let us have the van back at no charge.
Good thinking.
Coolsville Towing, what do you want?
Hi, we believe you may have towed our van.
Oh, the one that looks like a hippie queer threw up all over it?
That's the one.
There's gonna be a $300 release fee, plus the $100 ticket for parking in a no parking zone.
I don't think you understand. This is Mystery Inc.
Who?
Mystery Inc. You know, Fred, Daphne, Shaggy, Velma, the dog. We're kind of famous in this town. Surely you've heard of us.
For one, my name's not Shirley, it's Beatrice. And for two, I don't have the slightest idea who you are. So, either pay the $300 fine, or say goodbye to your little hippie faggot van.
Could you, like, look us up?
I said, $300 release fee, plus the $100 ticket, unless you bring me some cigarettes. I'm kidding about the cigarettes, I need the money, but some cigarettes would be nice. Okay. Fuck off.
Where are we going to find $400?
Oh, I know. I saved that prize money from when we caught the cotton candy monster in case of emergencies.
Where is it?
I told Shaggy to hold on to it.
Shaggy?
Yes, Fred?
Where did you put the money?
Well,
what? You still have it, don't you?
No.
And why not?
Well, you see, it's a funny story when you mention it, because I was running really low on grass last week, and my regular guy was out of town, so I had to go on Craigslist, and I found this guy named Derek, and he charged a lot more than what my regular guy does, so I had to spend all the money on weed.
You used the money for drugs!
Hey, weed is not a drug, it's a lifestyle.
Now what?
According to the spire, there's a $1,000 reward for whoever catches this ghost mask killer.
Like zoinks, that's enough money to pay the fine and buy more weed.
It's in a different town, though.
Where is it?
Woodsboro.
Well, gang, get in the van. We're going to Woodsboro.
The van is gone, Fred.
Someone call an Uber. We're going to Woodsboro.
Oh, wow. You kids are so bright and colorful.
Oh,
almost reminds me of a 60s show I used to watch.
Scooby-Doo?
No! The one with the dog!
Scooby-Doo!
No, the one with the blonde.
Scooby-Doo!
No! The one that...
You know, they're always chasing a ghost, and then they reveal it, and it's like they've known him all along, and it's crazy!
Scooby-Doo!
Oh, you're right! Scooby-Doo! That show always had me so nervous.
Well, gang, we made it. Now let's go find that ghost.
Can we get some McDonald's first? I'm starving.
Come on, Shaggy. The faster we solve this case, the quicker we can get the van back. So where should we start? Maybe that creepy old mansion. That's usually where ghosts hang out.
Oh, no. You guys go have fun. I'm gonna wait out here.
Oh, come on, you pussy. Might I remind you we wouldn't have to do this if you didn't spend the money?
Might I remind you we wouldn't have to do any of this if you parked the van in a parking spot?
I don't like you.
Would you do it for a Scooby snack?
Is Velma still a virgin? Yes. The answer is yes.
Now let's go catch a ghost.
Smoke weed every day.
Hello.
Raggy.
Scooby, how you feeling, buddy?
Great. Right, ready to draw wristeries again.
Oh, Scoob, I'm sorry, but we just started a new case. We should be done soon, though, so just take a little bit more time to yourself and we'll be home as fast as we can.
Okay.
Love you, Scoob. I'm glad you're feeling better.
Smoke weed every day.
What is it now, Scooby?
Hello, Shaggy.
Like, who's this?
Not important.
How did you know my name?
I'm a big fan of yours, Shaggy. You're by far the best member of Mystery Inc.
Like zoinks, man. Thanks.
I just have one question for you.
Well, ask away.
What's your favorite scary movie?
White Chicks.
That's not a scary movie.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No, it's fucking not.
Oh. Well, to be fair, I did eat a lot of edibles before watching it.
Shaggy, what's taking so long?
Oh, well, it was groovy talking to you, but I gotta go. Coming!
I'm gonna get you back, Vanny. If it's the last thing I do. Come on, gang.
Like, it's even spookier on the inside.
You know, sometimes it amazes me you ever got laid.
You and me both, man.
Jinkies, come look at this painting. Is it just me, or does this painting look like our Uber driver?
Not really.
I don't see it.
Yeah, not at all. What's an Uber?
Well, gang, I think it's time we split up and look for clues.
I choose Fred.
You know, Daphne, we always go together. Maybe we can switch it up this time, you know. Boys go with boys, girls go with girls.
I'm a boy.
Actually, I was kinda thinking maybe I should team up with Shaggy tonight.
Of course you would.
Looks like it's you and me, Freddy.
Yay! I'm so excited! Fucking.
Wait, Shaggy. Before we go and look for clues, can we talk outside for a second?
Okay.
Like, what do you want to talk about?
Well, you see, I'm kind of in love with you. I have been since the day we've met. There's just something about your long, greasy hair, your Slenderman body, and your weed breath.
So thanks, Velma. I'm flattered. But I have a confession to make, too. I'm in love with you.
Really?
Really.
So, do you want to, like, go out with me?
Sure.
Groovy. Hey, this will probably sound really dumb, but can we kiss? I've never kissed anyone, and I want my first kiss to be with you.
Wait, you've never kissed anyone before?
I know, I'm pathetic.
No, it's fine. I've never had my first kiss either.
Wait, really? What about that one girl you slept with?
It was pity sex. She wouldn't let me touch her with anything but my junk. She wouldn't even let me look at her.
Oh?
But yes, I'd love to be your first kiss.
Jinkies, that would make me yours too. I'm nervous. What if I'm not good at it?
Wouldn't have anything to compare it to.
How do we do it?
I don't know, just, pucker up your lips.
Whoa, I can't believe that just happened.
So, like, how was it?
Amazing. You might be the best kisser to exist.
Thanks.
I wonder what Fred and Daphne are doing right now.
The work here, least you could do is open your mouth.
Sorry, Daph. I'm trying my best. It just... I'm just not feeling it tonight, you know?
Oh, you're not feeling it tonight. Well, you're not feeling it any other night, or morning, or afternoon. Oh my god. Fred, do you like... penis?
No, of course not.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm sure.
Okay. You wanna keep on going?
I'm gonna go see if this place has a bathroom. I'll be right back. You know, I think I saw the TV in the other room. Maybe when I get back we can, like, watch The Bachelor instead? Does that sound like a cool idea? What was that? That sounds like an amazing idea, Fred? Well, thank you, Daphne. Yeah, yeah. We'll do that.
He's definitely gay, right? That explains why he wears my underwear.
This is like my first Grindr date all over again. Real nice place you picked, Velma. Shaggy? Is that you? I knew I wasn't the only fruit in the group. I love the gloves. It's very sexy. But listen, I really shouldn't. I'm very discreet. What if one of the others walk in? I don't want them to know that I'm gay.
We all know you're gay, Fred.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm doing it! I deserve it after pretending to love that dumbass redhead for as long as I have, just so she'll stay in the group. I haven't felt the touch of a man in so long. You're gonna, like, actually do anything? That hurt. Oh god, it still hurts. I'm gonna assume this is your first time. No teeth, okay? Oh god. It's hurt. Why can't I feel my dick? You cut my dick off! You cut my fucking dick off!
Shaggy, I can't find Fred anywhere. He went to the bathroom an hour ago and never came back.
I'm sure he's around here somewhere.
Hello?
I got a delivery from a Mr. Ghostface. Are you Mr. Ink?
Like Zoinks, yeah.
Perfect! Perfect!
Jinkies, I wonder what it could be.
Please be weed, please be weed, please be weed!
Damn it, it's just a cock!
Wait, that's just not any cock. I recognize that limp, pathetic dick anywhere. That's Fred's.
Jinkies.
Like Zoinks, what is Fred's dick doing in a box?
Hello?
I see you've received my present.
Yeah, but for future reference, I would prefer a gift card.
What did you do with Fred?
Let's just say he's with the queer angels in the sky.
Jeepers!
What did he say?
Fred is dead!
Alright, well that's my cue to leave. You guys can stay here if you want, but I'm hitchhiking back to Coolsville.
Come on, Shaggy! We have to figure out who's doing this!
We ain't gonna do shit!
Scooby Snack?
Well, when you put it like that, I guess I can stay for a little longer.
Jinkies.
Like Zoinks, man, run!
Fuck noise. Jinkies, where are my glasses? I can't see without my glasses. I knew I should have worn contacts. Shaggy? I can't see without my eyes!
Velma?
Velma?
Velma!
Oh, Zoinks, this isn't my fault.
If I didn't leave you by yourself, you'd still be alive.
I promise I'll find the person who did this to you, Velma.
Velma's dead, which means it's just you and me left.
I really wish you were here, buddy. I don't know how to do this without you.
Raggy?
Scooby, you're here.
Where's the others?
They're dead, Scoob. A man in a ghost mask killed them all. We gotta stop him, Scoob. We gotta.
Where is he?
I don't know. Oinks, oinks, Scoob, where are we?
Shaggy Rogers and Mr. Scooby-Doo, so nice of you and your friends to stop by today. It's been real fun.
Please, Mr. Ghostface, let Scooby go. Take me instead.
I was actually going to let Scooby pick your fate.
Well, obviously he's gonna let me live. He's my best pal.
Which is why I'm going to make this more difficult for him. Either let Shaggy live and you both walk out of here unharmed, or Shaggy dies and I give you a gift card for free Scooby snacks for life.
Come on, you really think he's gonna choose Scooby snacks over me?
I don't know, Raggy. It rounds really good.
Scooby, you can't be serious.
Randy Raven always been the best to me.
If this is about the time that I made you lick peanut butter off of my balls, I said I was sorry.
At least you raff balls.
Right. Look, if you let me live, I promise I'll make it up to you someday.
So, Scooby-Doo, what do you choose?
I choose... Raggy.
No. You were supposed to pick the Scooby snacks.
Sorry, Mr. Psycho Killer, but mine and Scooby's bond is too strong.
Rah.
I'll just kill you anyways.
Wait.
What?
Can a man get one last Scooby snack before you kill him?
I don't see why not.
Now it's time to see who you really are.
Like, zoinks, who the fuck are you?
Beatrice Gold, Mr. Ying's biggest fan. I admired you all for the longest time, since I was a little girl to be exact. I watched your show every day. There was nothing in life I wanted more than to be a part of your crew. To get to wear outdated, unwashed 60s clothes every day and not get judged for it. To be able to go after monsters for a living and be praised for it at the end of every day. I sent you guys thousands of letters explaining my love for y'all, but I never got a response to any of them. And when I saw one of you in person, I was ignored.
Fred Jones?
Yeah?
Oh my god! I'm your biggest fan! Look, I love all of you! I'm so excited to see you! I have a really big question to ask you! I wanted to ask
Hold that thought. I gotta take this. Hello? Yeah, I'll be there at 6. See you, Daph. Now, what were you gonna say?
Broken years of worshipping you guys, and for what?
So I decided to kill all of you. I'm surprised you don't recognize me. I've been following you guys around all day.
Wait, really?
Yeah, the Uber driver, the mailman. I mean, I'm the one who towed your van.
Whoa. Your disguises are really good.
Thanks.
Listen, sorry for killing your friend and all, but, you know, could you not call the police? I'm not trying to go back to prison, you know.
Are you kidding me? You butchered my friends. I spent my whole life with those people. Of course I'm calling the police.
I got weed.
You know, on second thought, fuck the police.
Ike, what the fuck did you put in this man?
Why?
I'm seeing some freaky shit, man.
I don't know, to be honest. I don't really look into the shit I get. This could be laced with meth for all we know.
Fair enough, I guess. You know, you didn't have to kill Velma. She wasn't like the others, and I was just getting to know her.
I didn't kill Velma!
What do you mean?
I mean, I didn't kill her! I only killed Daphne, dumb bitch, was standing out in the open! She was an easy target. The rest of y'all were too goddamn fast for my old lady legs to keep up with. But believe me, I tried. Really, I tried.
But wait. If you didn't kill Velma, or Fred, then who did? You got any more of that shit?